What's up, Taiwan? I'm Ethan Liu with news from here in Taiwan and around the world. Taiwan is planning to create a new sports ministry. While the country is still basking in the afterglow from the Paris Olympics, the government has announced a task force to prepare for the new government body. Cindy Chi has the details.
Taiwan has begun work on creating a new ministry for physical education and sports development. The government says it will set up a team tasked with upgrading the sports administration currently under the education ministry. The announcement follows the conclusion of the 2024 Summer Olympics in Paris. Taiwan secured a total of 7 medals at the Games, 2 gold and 5 bronze, marking the country's second highest medal count ever. One of the athletes on the team is Li Yang, a Paris Olympic gold medalist. He successfully defended his title with his partner Wang Qiling in the men's badminton doubles. Li has high hopes for this new ministry. President Lai Ching-de included plans for the new ministry in his inaugural address in May.
我们也期待一个更健康的台湾，成立体育暨运动发展部，推展全民运动。
Currently, over $5.52 billion has been allocated to the plan for 2025. Continued funding is expected to reach the $616 million goal set by President Lai by 2027. With the help of this new ministry, the government aims to provide long-term support for athletes and promote a healthier future for Taiwan. Ethan Pan and Sunny Chi for TaiwanPlus.
The Taipei court has ruled against the transgender woman's request to change her gender identity on personal documents without undergoing surgery or psychiatric evaluation. Our reporter Irene Ling spoke to the plaintiff Vivi about her reaction to the ruling and what more needs to be done in the future.
Vivi, the court has ruled that you would need one psychiatrist instead of the legally required two to prove that you're a woman. How do you feel about that?
我觉得感觉蛮复杂的，因为觉得说好像法官还是要求说跨性别者的性别认同要被肯定的话，还是需要有精神科医师的诊断。那这样子好像又把跨性别就是归类在就是需要被医生诊断，然后好像是一种疾病吗？或者是一个很特殊的状况？因为现在已经说不需要手术，就是手术已经不已经是违反人权，甚至是非必要的。但如果既然是这样的话，那为什么就是我现在的状态其实是一个稳定的认同，但是又需要透过医生诊断，我才能被承认我的法定性别是性别认同是一个女生这样子。What
are your next steps following today's ruling?
因为现在是停在高等行政法院，那我们会再去上诉到最高行政法院。对，那如果最高行政法院还是败诉的话，那我们就会再上诉到宪法法庭那边去，对，就会去申请大法官释宪。The
successful rulings in the past were all judged on a case-by-case basis, and the actual legal process for someone to change their ID genders has not caught up with these decisions. How do you think your case will make a difference?
就像现在其实我在打这个诉讼案，其实是一个算是策略性诉讼，希望可以推动政府去更正式跨性别的状况。对，但是就是因为行政跟立法就是一直不作为，所以跨性别者的权益就会更往后被推迟到更后面去，因为大家觉得这个不重要。但是因为社会大众没办法接受，就是因为教育还有这些法律根本就没有去好好正式跨性别者，所以就是导致这些一直在进行一个循环。
That was transgender plaintiff Vivi speaking from Taipei on her legal battle to change her gender marker. Taiwan plans to expand its rental subsidy program as the country sees a growing number of applications.
从去年呢，我们在第二次来开办的这一个租金补贴呢，原预定是50万户，但实际呢，截至目前为止已经申请了81万多户，那核准的这个户数也已经超过了60万户。
The government is planning annual total rent subsidies of over $900 million and will loosen the requirements to apply for it. The expansion will increase the number of subsidized households from 120,000 to 500,000 across the country. The program was introduced to help the housing needs of disadvantaged groups and young people. A TSMC packaging plant is going ahead after months of environmental assessment. Taiwan's Environment Ministry has now approved a revised plan for the project. It pledges to up recycled water use and reduce waste discharge further. It also allows for more recycling of materials dug up on the site. Plans for the packaging plant in Jiayi has stalled over water and land usage concerns. Advanced semiconductor packaging demands heavy water use and produces wastewater, which could impact local reservoirs. The local government says it has reserved land for the project.
那把这两个从化区相连，所以面积一共有367公顷。那刚好啊，这边所产生的主事方未来可以合作，那就进入到整个从化区。
Mountains of trash are piling up across Taiwan, and the country's waste incinerators are at capacity. With little movement in the legislature on the issue, activists are demanding action from the country's cabinet. Chris Gorin reports.
Dressed head to toe in garbage and tired of inaction, these protesters say they're waiting for a meeting with Taiwan's premier, Zhuo Rongtai. They want answers about a nationwide problem, trash mountains. Taiwan produces so much trash that its waste incinerators can't keep up. And the trash is piling up in temporary dumps, 1 to 2 stories high, while waiting to be burned. The trash mountains can be smelled from a long way away, pollute local water resources, and create fire hazards. One 10-meter-tall trash mountain in northern Taiwan recently caught fire for the second time in less than 8 months. And activists say they've had enough.
其实这个问题非常严重，再不从根本去解决的话，全台可能就会堆出越来越多的垃圾山，还有现在的垃圾山可能也只会越来越高。There
are at least 107 of these temporary trash dumps spread throughout the country, and they're estimated to hold 840,000 tons of garbage, equal to the weight of nearly 8.5 Nimitz-class aircraft carriers. And the problem is likely to get worse, as the average amount of trash each person in Taiwan produces is actually increasing. And government officials don't paint a rosy picture.
我们到底什么时候可以把暂存厂能够降到去化掉？那这个还要几年的时间。This
hazy time frame is why these activists want a meeting with the premier. And while Joel didn't show up himself, other cabinet staff did.
应该是这样讲哈，就是说，其实我们其实非常重视这个问题，所以院长本人也很重视吗？对，所以呢，那他可不可以出来，让我们递交这个，可以帮我们去请他吗？
这样就好了。But the protesters found the response lacking.
我们就不满意啊，认为这样子的回答答复呢，其实是不够的。为什么？因为其实，在我们做出这样子的沟通之后，行政院的表示呢，是说会交代环境部来邀请我们一起去视察垃圾山。其实我们这边没有得到任何的邀请，没有得到任何的这个通知，要一起去见证这个垃圾山的状况。所以让在地的居民他们的心声其实都没有办法传达出去。The
premier may not have answered questions from activists this time, but with years of trash still left to burn, neither these trash mountains nor the public pressure to deal with them are going away. Chris Ma and Chris Gorin for Taiwan Plus.
Taiwan officially has some new national treasures. The Culture Ministry gave the title to 5 sets of historic Buddhist scriptures in the National Palace Museum's collection. The museum is home to a trove of priceless Chinese artifacts brought to Taiwan during the communist takeover of China. The 5 richly decorated manuscripts date from China's last imperial dynasty and feature Buddhist texts in the Tibetan and Manchu languages. Experts say these exquisite editions contain both religious and cultural value.
所有的经文都是用泥金手写的，包括它的所有的边框，就每一页都有边框，木刻，然后再去香金，然后香各种珍宝的。金版上面有一些佛菩萨、护法神的这些形象，也都是用手绘的。
Japan's leaders have reiterated a pledge to never again go to war. The comments came during the ceremony marking the 79th anniversary of the end of World War II.
戦争の惨禍を二度と繰り返さない。戦後79年が経ちますが、歳月がいかに流れても、この決然たる誓いを世代を超えて継承し、貫いてまいります。
The comments from the Prime Minister echo the language of Japan's post-war constitution, which renounces war powers and military forces. Japan has, however, maintained what it calls a purely defensive military to defend its territory. Kishida's tenure has seen Japan double military spending and acquire new weapons, citing perceived threats from North Korea and China.Thailand's ruling political party, PTAI, has chosen Pettongtarn Shinawatra as their candidate to be the next leader of the country. That's after Thailand's top court removed the party's Setback Thavisin as prime minister, saying the real estate tycoon broke ethics rules by appointing a convict to the cabinet. The dismissal adds to ruling political drama in Thailand, and the new leader must now be voted in from the pool of candidates from last year's election. For more on Thailand's search,For a new leader, Joy Tseng speaks with political scientist Puchada Sirivanabut in Bangkok.
With the PTAI party's Setback Thavisin now removed as prime minister, what is the process for Thailand to choose its new leader, and how soon can we expect for this to happen?
This is kind of surprising because we thought that it's going to take some time, but it seems like PTAI party, call all the member of MP and also other political party in the coalition government to meet with Thaksin Shinawatra yesterday at night. It's kind of an emergency because, most of the PTAI parties and Setback himself, I think they thought that they are going to survive and Setback can continue to be in power. Tomorrow at 10 o'clock, they call for the parliament meeting to select and to vote for the prime minister.PTAI want to put forward a lot of policy at this time, for example, the digital wallet, the soft power policy, and also the 400 baht for the new labor wage. And they're trying to push all this kind of policy as soon as possible.
And what are PTAI's chances at keeping the top seat?
For tomorrow meeting, I think that PTAI will definitely control the seat.For Chai Kasem, because PTAI got a large number of seats. I don't think that there are going to be any problem. I think PTAI can also negotiate with other political party as well, and also the pro-military political parties.
Prime Minister Setback's dismissal is the second major constitutional court ruling in just 2 weeks. The court also ordered the anti-establishment Move Forward Party, which won last year's elections, general elections, to disband. What do you make of these decisions and the direction for Thai politics?
Setback and Move Forward Party should not be dissolved by the court because, they were in power because they get a large number of support and support from the people. For the Move Forward, they got elected and they got a large number of seats by, a large number of voters across Thailand. The same as Setback, he became the prime minister because he was dominated by the party that, I would say they have a chance to form the coalition government and they won the second largest parties in the last election.These politicians, they are from the people, they are the representative of the people. So if you can have some kind of court to do whatever, to disband them or to kick them out of the politics, I don't think it's a good thing for the democratic development in the long run.
That was Joy Tseng speaking with political scientist Puchada Sirivanabut in Bangkok. Thank you for watching today's What's Up Taiwan. You can visit the TaiwanPlus website and follow our social media for more stories from Taiwan and around the world. Finally, check out this colorful aurora spotted in the skies above Scotland. I'm Ethan Liu. Take care, and I'll see you next time.